Our next speaker her name is Gayatri. She will be joining us today live from Madhya Pradesh in India, more specifically a place called Bhopal. And Gayatri was born in this beautiful hills near the Dharmashala in Himachal Pradesh in India to a farming family. Her passion for agriculture and rural development led her to gather deep expertise and to working in solving some of the most pressing challenges for farmers in India. From her early age, Gayatri started working to train farmers on sustainable agriculture practices. She's an awesome entrepreneur. She helped start the Green Leaf Produce, a project designed to organize smallholder farmers to grow appropriate food and access new markets. And interestingly, in 2016, she received the Hubert Humphrey Fellow, a very prestigious award, of course, and attended Cornell University in the US to further her knowledge. She is a role model for many farmers and especially girls in India. And during my first conversation with her earlier this week, I was immediately impressed by her knowledge, her passion for her work. So without further ado, let me just transfer over this to Gayatri and let's hear more from Gayatri. Over to you, Gayatri.
Thank you, Deepak. Thank you so much for this beautiful introduction. Hello, everyone. My name is Gayatri. I'm from India. To be specific, I'm from the North Province. And I am a smallholder farmer growing wheat, paddy, corn, and vegetables. And as you would know, like in India, more than 70% of farmers are smallholder farmer who cultivates in less than 2 hectare farms. So as I am, and we cultivate in hilly region of North Province. Like my father and I initially practices traditional methods, which was very time consuming and we have very little access of the modern technologies such as, you know, available to the farmer in other countries, such as weather information, when to harvest, when to plant the crops and improve seed and technologies, seed tool technology and market related information. So, that all made me realize that if we have this agriculture extension and advisory services, which can make our life more efficient and productive. Then I started to access the extension services, which helps me and other farmer to grow like, you know, better produce in our farms. So I would like to add a little story here, which is like how I have started to grabbing this extension services. So there was a time I was visiting to a seed store, and there was a agriculture extension officer happened to visit there, and he was speaking with this storekeeper that we are organizing a training. And I asked what training you are organizing. He said, like, we are organizing a seasonal vegetables training. I said, okay, I want to attend that training. Can I attend? He said, oh, absolutely, you can join us. And that was the day, like, you know, I got that opportunity and where I got introduced with the subject matter specialist, you know, like the rice specialist, wheat specialist, potato specialist. And it was like, I was thrilled, like, you know, like, wow, that's what I was looking for. I was wondering for years, and today I got that, all the things. So yeah, that's how like extension services came into my life. And interestingly that my small farmer soon became a experiential farm for youth and farmers, where I was able to demonstrate modern technology such as new seed, new or improved seed technology, etc. And then that helped me, and then that helped me to organize the exposure visits for farmers to train them in the best way to show the results. Although I was very happy, you know, I was very happy that helping to my community, and I was happy to helping community, but there was something in my heart that I want to help more people. And like my outreach was limited at that point of time. And meanwhile, I became, I was elected as a farmer friend in my province. And that time I was became a bridge between farmer and agriculture agencies. And that extended my outreach to the more and more farmer. And I was able to help more than 300 farmer family who benefited with government schemes and such as making the compost pits, different type of compost and compost pits at their farmland. And also the exposure visit and accessing these services, market services and technology and that all. So that was really very, very exciting for me. And also the other interesting thing was that I started this, SRI technique, the system of rice intensification. And that technique was that double the farm, almost double their production. And farmer was very happy with the production. And I'm excited that the farmers are continuing that without my help. So that's how opportunity rising and rising. And then soon after I started, as you mentioned in the introduction, that I started a farmer enterprise called Greenleaf, where about 39 farmer got collective and started growing this chemical free produce, and we provide them the market and advisory and extension services. And one of the touching story from this farmer enterprise, there's a woman called Kaushalya Devi. She was from a poor family, and she has a very small piece of land which was not sufficient to grow food produce to sell in the market. So with help of me, she rented another piece of land, and where she started growing food produce and selling into the market with new technology and techniques. And soon after, her economic status grown up, and then she was able to send her kids to the private school. As you know, in India, private schools consider a good school. So she was sending her kids to the private school, and also she renovated her home, her house, which the wall was falling almost up 7-8 years, and they were unable to renovate that. So she renovated that, and also she bought a mobile and refrigerator first time in her life. And also the family nutrition's health also improved in her family. So that was that I consider my achievement and most, the biggest accomplishment of my life. And I hope to help more farmer like her, to more farmer in the coming state. Yeah, thanks.
Well done, Gayatri. I mean, that's such an amazingly inspiring story, and you know, for so many of us working in the food systems, you are truly our food hero. So Gayatri, during this session and the earlier one with David and Jake, we were talking a little bit about listening and adapting and having the knowledge to adapt. That was quite an important emerging theme that came through, and I wanted to ask you, because you've been on both sides of this argument, as a farmer receiving information and utilizing it for your own good, and also as a trainer, because you did a lot of work on the extension services, right? So what are the important lessons that you've learned yourself on training farmers? Because there are so many other smallholder farmers across the world, in Asia and Africa and Central and Latin America. What are the lessons that we can extract from your own experience?
Very, very interesting and valid question you have asked, Deepak. So as a trainer and as a bridge between farmer and agency, so I realized that if we want, my learning is that if we want to see smallholder farmer as a prosperous, so then they need to have this extension advisory services and technical solution for their farm and market services, market access to market. If they have these all the things in their hand, available in their hand, no one can stop them to be a prosper farmers. That is my learning. Yeah.
Okay, that's an interesting one. And of course, that comes from your own sort of drive to do better and your own eagerness. You talked about how when that opportunity came for you to attend a training, how excited and enthusiastic you are, right? So that's really an inspiring story. Now, Gayatri, the earlier video, I'm sure you saw that as well, with Jake driving this amazing combine harvester in Canada, right? That's for us here in Asia. I'm working here in Bangladesh, you're in India. That's like a rocket ship. You know, we can't even imagine something like that here. But in the context of where we work, where you work in Bhopal, where I work in Bangladesh, what are some of the technologies that you've seen that can transform farmers' lives, especially smallholder farmers?
Interesting. Yeah. So technology. So as I already mentioned in my first questionnaire, you asked me that are my learnings. So technology based on the, you know, the farm size and where. Technology based on the farm size and farmer. And I would recommend, support here the women-friendly tools also, because we have seen that there is very, very few tools which is women-friendly. Mostly they are heavy and so women are unable to access. I mean, it's difficult for women to access that tools. So one is the women-friendly tools. And the second one is based on the farm size and the small power tiller and irrigation tools and harvesting tools, which is very, very friendly. And also, you know, the weather information, to grab the weather information so that farmer get to know like, okay, so rain is going to happen, so let's harvest or let's bait. Well, you know, so that kind of technology, if that is available for the farmers, that would help to more and more farmers.
And you are in the forefront of making these technologies accessible, right? It's about right sizing technology. It's about designing appropriate technology, affordable technologies, technologies that work in the context to our farming system. So that's great. Now, the last question before we hand this over. To you, Gayatri, is you have a double challenge. You are a farmer also, you know, and also a woman in a context like South Asia. How do you handle this? What's the secret of your success? How do you balance your work, your life, being a food hero, being a role model for so many people in India? What's your success? What's your secret of your success?
My passion for the farming and for the farmers. For the farming industry to make the farmer's life happy, healthy, and prosperous, and my dedication to health. So that is the secret.